Hi everyone, today I'm going to show you how to make cute models with a technique called gradient textures or gradient texturing. There's really no official name for it, at least for what I'm aware, but that's the name I commonly heard people use. So it's pretty simple to explain what it actually is about. It's in the name, so you map different gradients to your model. I think here in the leaf it's pretty obvious, so you have like brighter green here going to a darker green. And it's, yeah, basically repeated for all the different parts. So yeah, this workflow is really cool if you want to save work. For example, your small team working on a game, or maybe you're taking part in a game jam, then this is really good. Because you save a lot of work with this and a lot of time. Before I'm going to show you a step-by-step tutorial, let's actually look at this guy so you get a general idea what this is about and how it works. So now here in UV editing mode, you can see the model. Now if I select the part, you can see I mapped it to gradient here. Normally with a UV map, of course, you would want to use the UV space as efficient as possible and use as much of it as you can, but here you really don't need to with this workflow. You have kind of this color palette of different gradients. You can make this in any software you like, Photoshop, GIMP, Krita, whatever you like really. And then you just map the different parts of the model on that. And how you exactly do that, I'm gonna show you in a bit. But yeah, that's the basic idea. I also wanted to show you this here. This is Ooplets. If you don't know this game yet, it's really cute. And it's what originally got me into this workflow. And here you can also really see the gradients going on here. For example, this flower. All right, but now let's actually get into a step-by-step tutorial on how to do that. All right, so now we're in another file with just the model without textures. If you look in the bottom left here, I enabled the keys on the screen so you can see what I'm doing without me having to say it always. And yeah, let's walk you through like how to actually texture this guy. So the first thing I want to do before we actually get into here is make a palette. So I already made one here. Ignore this. This is just me using the rest of the texture space for some additional textures. But yeah, this really doesn't have to mean anything. I can also show you another example. One second. Here. This I picked from different Ooplets models themselves because I wanted to make fan art of it. But yeah. You basically don't have to adhere to a certain size, so this is 512 by 512, but you could also make it 64 by 64. It doesn't have to be square or anything, and also like the sizes of the gradients don't really matter, just like make basically a file with different gradients. Right, so that's the basic idea. And once you have made a file like this in Photoshop, GIMP, Krita, or anything of your choosing, then you go back into Blender. So now as we can see here, that's like how Blender will look by default. So you have kind of this shiny material with some shadows and some light. But actually for this style, we don't want to have any light information. So on top here, on the top right, make first sure you have a solid view, which is this guy. You can also press Z and select solid. And then you want to switch here to flat. If there's no texture on the model, it should just look white like this. That's all fine. Then we switch to texture. And lastly, we switch to cavity. Now this all should just be white because we didn't set up any material, any texture yet. So yeah, at this point it should look like this for you. Now I already have it selected, but yeah, you want to go on the right and select the material you hear. And make sure we have all models selected. Then we press new, create a new material. I'm gonna give it a name. I'm just gonna call it, I don't know, tutorial for this sake, but it really doesn't matter what name you give it. Okay, now that we have done that, we have created our material. Oops, tutorial. We want to switch to UV editing up here. Oh wait, no, not UV editing, sorry, in shading. We want to go to shading first. And for some reason, we kind of have to repeat the steps we did before. Blender doesn't copy it between the different workspaces. I don't know why. I guess it kind of makes sense. But yeah, let's just repeat that. And make sure our material is selected. So yeah, you can use the drop down here in case it isn't. And should just look like this. Don't worry, this might be a bit intimidating, but you actually don't need to worry about all those options. We just need to use this guy. Because we don't have any light information, any normals or anything, not any fancy stuff, we just use the color texture. Also a thing I forgot to mention with this. It will actually be one-to-one, like the textures you use, the colors you use on your texture will also be the colors you get in the end, because you don't have any lighting information. Alright, so just drag and drop that in here, and then we're gonna connect those guys up. Just left click and then connect those guys. And yeah, if you did everything right until this point, then we should already, we shouldn't be already textured like how I did here, but you should see like some texture. I can just show you how it would look like most likely. Should look probably something like this, basically the whole texture mapped onto the model. And now you can put our crayons on the different parts. So for that, you can see already this red parts already have some UV seams, and UV seams are really useful if you want to have some transition. Wait, let me just go back so I can show you. Can see I have this shadow here, so I added a UV seam so I can have this clear border. I'm gonna show you a bit more on how to exactly do that in a little bit. But yeah. Okay, so let's just I'm gonna show you an example of this. Gonna select the whole model and then clear our seam. Let's first set up a general projection. So with the gradient textures, the way it works, depending on how you project your UV maps, it's also like how the gradients are gonna point. So for example, if I would project it from here, you would get the gradient going this direction. You can see it's kind of the perspective we projected it from. And now, I don't know, I'm just gonna pick this because it makes it easy to see. We scale it up on our gradient, so it goes, the highest part goes there and the lowest part there. You can also place in between depending on the effect you want. But you can see I projected from there, so you get kind of this gradient. But yeah, here for most uses I want things to be a bit more precise. So for that, what you can use is the gradient, not the gradient view, the orthographic view. And to activate that, you press numpad 5 when you go into orthographic view, and then you can switch between the different views. So 3 would be the right one, 1 would be what's called front, but for me it's usually not the front, and 7 would be up. That's the one I most commonly use. And now it's like really easy to like precisely projected. So now if you go U, project from U, you get it exactly from the front. And you switch back to V editing, you can see it's like really, really clean. And this will also make it later easy to make a grab like a piece of it, basically. Let's say you want to have this guy and move it to a specific part of the gradient. That's gonna get way easier if we unwrap it like this. All right, so now I think put this guy here before we're just gonna scale it down, and then I want it to basically go from the brightest point to the darkest point as well, so we're gonna stretch it almost to the full length of the gradient like this. Make sure it's not bleeding over into any other gradients. I can show you how that would look. You suddenly get like this color getting in there, so leave some room on the sides. All right, now that we have that done, let's add back the shadow. So I'm gonna roof that window. Okay. Order to do that, make sure you are into edge mode, which is either up here, you can also press 2 on your keyboard. And then we press Ctrl E and select Mark C. Oh, sorry, I didn't mention, in case you don't know, you select an edge loop by Alt and left click. Or you can also select it manually just by holding Shift and selecting a different edges. Okay, now that we have that selected, it's way easier for us to select just this part and have like this harsh transition. So, yeah, switch to face mode, which is either up here, you press 3 on the keyboard, and then do L to select all the link parts, which will select all the top part. Actually, let me show you. It actually looks quite funny up here if you move the head. Okay, so yeah, you're gonna again do 5 to go into a graphic view, and then 3 to go into like the right view. Please note, don't do that with the normal numbers. Do definitely with the numpad, it won't work with the normal numbers. So in case you had some problems just now, it probably was because you pressed the normal numbers. But yeah, now we have the shadow here. I'm gonna move it to this color. You can see we have this really like clean, harsh transition. Let's actually move the pot back on his head. Okay. Can see we have a little shadow here. Okay, now one last thing I want to show you, which is quite important with this workflow. So let's say I'm going to show you with the head maybe. Let's move it to a different color. So it's a bit easier to see, just for the sake of demonstration. Gonna make his pot head purple. But now let's say we have like this gradient here, and we want maybe in here to be also like bright part like this. So the way we would do that is first we go up here with the arrows that will enable linked selection. What that means is basically everything you select here in this editing mode will also be selected in UV editing mode. And I'd suggest you do it that way, because it can get very chaotic with this workflow, as you can see here. So if you would try to select an UV window all the time, it can be pretty hard to, and you might make some mistakes. So it's way easier to do just a linked selection and select it here. But yeah, now that we do that, we just can move it up the gradient. And voila, it's also got the bright color. Now, if you want to like control like how big that part is, can do that. For that, I'm actually gonna, I want to add another edge loop, but for some reason it doesn't let me. I think I have like some setting enabled, whatever. well, that's like, can't do Control R right now. That's weird. Okay, well, it doesn't matter really. I can show you anyway. So yeah, I'm just gonna select this edge loop and move it all the way down to the dark part. And you can see, hopefully, how this part is kind of decreasing. So I'm just gonna move it back to where it was. You can see now we have like almost all the bright color, but now if I move it down, I can really control how big that part is. And you can, for example, use that for clothing folds, or if you want to have a patterned top part, for example, that's nice. I'm actually gonna go out of link mode again. Sorry, I'm just gonna move it to a different color. So maybe then it's a bit more obvious. Yeah, can kind of see. Oh, now he looks really funky, but you can kind of see what I did there. Okay, yeah, that's the basic idea. I really hope you enjoyed. Once again, be sure to check the description. Oh, let me undo this guy so he looks normal again. This poor dude. Oh no. I'm out of undos. Okay, I guess he has a purple pot now. But yeah, I really hope you enjoyed. There's gonna be some more resources in the description. I'm also gonna link a tutorial for Maya users there. And also ModMod is really good to check out. He also uses this style. And yeah, I really hope you enjoyed, and I'm looking forward to the models you're gonna make with this approach.